Tonight, we know the driver fell asleep behind the wheel. But what we have uncovered about the driver and his company will give you the chills. Investigator Jim Parsons live tonight in Butler County. Jim.
Andrew, what happened here on 79 southbound near the Slippery Rock exit is plain to see. Here's where the tractor trailer went through the guide rail. And down below in the median is all that's left of the truck at this hour. Recovery efforts continue more than 12 hours after this wreck, all because a driver was too tired to keep driving. Sky 4 has the bird's eye view of what happened here. But it's at ground level that you can see just how frightening this wreck was. The 18-wheeler traveling southbound on 79 just plowed through the guardrail and flipped over into the highway median. And the reason was simple, but all too common.
Lost control of the vehicle because he had fallen asleep. Truck traveled into the median. Very fortunate that it was a ditch in the median to prevent him from crossing into other lanes.
State police say they'll cite the driver, his fourth moving violation in 2 years. As for the company, Buckler Transport out of Mifflin County, our investigation finds in the past 24 months, the company has had 34 U.S. DOT violations related to fatigued drivers. 10 of those violations were related to drivers working longer hours than allowed by federal law. As cleanup crews worked at removing the trailer and its load of motor oil, everyday motorists were left wondering about truck drivers falling asleep at the wheel.
Very scary. They could kill several people.
Does that ever enter your mind that that's something you have to be concerned about when you're driving next to one?
Sure, that's why I stay away from them.
Well, I know they drive very long shifts and that there are many of them on the road, and it's definitely something to watch out for.
But the guys in this truck say safety isn't that complicated. What's the secret to not suffering from fatigue when you're behind the wheel in long distances?
I would say the hours of time you're behind the wheel. I mean, we put 8 hours in, sometimes nine, but no, it's no more than that.
A recovery crews, those guys working down there, they say they'll be at this for several more hours, and you know what that means on a Friday afternoon. This is looking back, 79 southbound, looking north. For several miles, this is backed up because PennDOT has this down to one lane for this recovery effort. There is one bit of good news. Incredibly, no one was injured in this wreck. Reporting live in northern Butler County, Jim Parsons, Channel 4 Action News.